That wasn't your teacher. This isn't your school. This entire world is not the world. We're inside a huge simulation chamber on an alien spaceship.
The digital age has seen the creation of simulated worlds in video games where anything and everything is possible. As technology progresses, so too does the believability of these worlds. Games may one day become indistinguishable from reality, providing immersive experiences with lifelike characters. But is it possible that we're the equivalent of a video game to someone else? This is Unveiled, and today we're uncovering the extraordinary reasons why simulation theory might be a reality. Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content? Questions about the nature of reality have been central to philosophy for thousands of years. According to idealism, which rose to prominence in the 19th century, reality is a mental construct, the product of consciousness. In the last century or so, the theory has fallen out of favor, eclipsed by materialism. But the idea that reality might be illusory or even a dream has persisted on the sidelines. Of these theories, the simulation hypothesis might be the most convincing. In fact, many famed thinkers such as Elon Musk and Neil deGrasse Tyson think it's more likely than not. The hypothesis states that our reality is merely a simulation, something like the Matrix where everything is code in some type of computer.
Have you ever had a dream, Neo, that you were so sure was real? What if you were unable to wake from that dream? How would you know the difference between the dream world and the real world?
Elon Musk is one of the best-known proponents of the hypothesis, giving the odds of us being in base reality at 1 in billions. But he's not the only one who gives the idea serious thought. There are reportedly 2 tech billionaires already working on a way to break us out of the simulation. The hypothesis was first formulated by Nick Bostrom in a 2003 paper entitled, "Are We Living in a Computer Simulation?" Since then, the idea has gained traction with a wide audience. NASA scientist Rich Terrell has argued that there's no reason that we can't eventually program consciousness into a computer, and that it's extraordinarily unlikely we're not in a simulation. He considers it a more reasonable hypothesis than believing that self-aware beings such as ourselves rose from nothing more than a primordial goo. It's a hypothesis that isn't easily knocked down. If advanced civilizations are able and willing to run such simulations and run huge numbers of them, the result would be more simulated minds than real minds. In other words, most minds would belong to one of the simulated realities, rather than the single base reality. Of course, this assumes that the reality we live in can be simulated. But that at least seems possible. Matter, for example, is finite and can be broken down into discrete units, with subatomic particles analogous to pixels in a video game. It might even soon be possible to code minds. In 2015, an international team of researchers was able to digitally recreate part of a rat's brain. If it's possible to upload entire brains, a concept called mind uploading, then how do we know that they haven't been already? And that our own brains aren't really uploads living in a simulated reality? There's some physical evidence in favor of the hypothesis too. For one, at the quantum level, phenomena exist in a superposition of different states until measured, what's known as the observer effect. It's been argued that this could be a way to save memory or processing power, rendering reality only when it's observed.
Looking good.
Slow down, my man!
Our DNA, too, is eerily similar to computer code. In fact, in 2017, a team of researchers at the University of Washington embedded actual computer code in a physical strand of DNA, highlighting just how similar the two may be. In addition, theoretical physicist James Gates claims to have identified computer code in a form of string theory, the closest theory to everything that we currently have. For some, the simulation hypothesis is also a more satisfactory explanation for so-called supernatural activity, as it can be put down to glitches in the program. Ghosts, for example, could be representations of past lives that accidentally become visible. If we are living in a simulation, can we ever escape?
Out of the simulation, Morty! Normally the chamber operates like a treadmill, with the virtual world disappearing behind us and being rendered in front of us as we move through it. But while it's frozen, Morty, we can get to the edge.
Well, aliens might provide a clue to that question. With the sheer number of planets in the cosmos and the staggering amount of time that the universe has existed, why haven't we observed intelligent extraterrestrial life? This is known as the Fermi paradox, and one potential explanation is that when civilizations become advanced enough, they learn to escape the simulation we all live in, meaning that aliens did exist in our universe once upon a time, but were able to escape before we came along. Our ultimate fate may be to learn how to escape our virtual prison and experience the real outer world. Then again, why would anyone create a simulation like ours in the first place? One hypothesis is that our future descendants created us in a simulation to see how we evolved and to potentially recreate the past by programming the same boundaries of reality. This is called an ancestor simulation. Another idea posits that we were created to solve a difficult problem that our programmers don't have enough time to figure out. This could potentially be climate change, as it's more than likely that an advanced civilization will initially burn fossil fuels for power and run into the same problems as us. If that's the case, we could be a simulation whose purpose is to solve climate change, a problem that, unfortunately, we haven't quite figured out yet. Or, like video games or movies, perhaps we're nothing more than entertainment, a reality show for higher beings to enjoy, to escape to, from their own dull existences. As technology progresses, we're looking more and more into the simulation hypothesis. When we do get to the point where our own computer simulations match reality, a possibility that's all but ensured in time, we may start escaping to these virtual worlds for more exciting lives. At that point, we'll already be living in simulations for at least some of our lives. There may even come a time when people go to work in simulations instead of physically traveling to their jobs and end up spending a majority of their lives in a virtual reality. It's no stretch to think that since it may one day be possible, we could already be living in one. And as our knowledge of science grows, we may be able to mathematically prove once and for all that everything we've ever known has been nothing more than code programmed into a higher being's computer. And that's why simulation theory might be a reality.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.